Idea, some of you?
हाँ ना,
नो 27, राइट ऑन 27 विल बी देयर. 11, यस माय डियर, म्यूट द माइक्रोफोन बिकॉज रिकॉर्डिंग हैज स्टार्टेड. स्टेट वेदर ट्रू और फॉल्स. स्टेट वेदर ट्रू और फॉल्स. So we have to check whether the given statement is true or false. First, A, 500 is the predecessor of 499. 500 is the predecessor of 499. Yes? Tell me, what is the predecessor of 499? Yes, 498. Yes, 499 minus 1 is 498. 498 is the predecessor. So the given statement is false because 500 is the successor. So the given statement is false. Because you are given 500 as the successor of 499. This also 498 arrow I have written predecessor. So the this you have to, no my dear, you have to show this. Why? You have to write down the reason also. 498 is the predecessor because from 499 when we subtract, for predecessor we subtract 1. 499 minus 1 will be 498. 498 is the predecessor of 499. And in the question, you are given 500. 500 is the successor. So the given statement is false. Because 500 is the successor, not predecessor. The predecessor is 490. The 500 is the successor. No, my dear, it is, no, it is very much clear, Ha, 700, mute the microphone, 700 is the successor, 700 is the successor of 699. Let us check. For successor, we add 1, 699 plus 1, it is 700. So 700 is the successor. 700 is the successor of 699. And you are given, so the given statement is true. Yes, mute the microphone. Whenever it is required, then only you speak in between. Then C part, the predecessor of a three-digit number, The predecessor of a three-digit number can never be a two-digit number. The predecessor of a two-digit number can never be a two-digit number. The predecessor of a three-digit number. Yes, three-digit number. Yes. Mute the microphone. So the predecessor of a three-digit number can never be a two-digit number. It is not true. Why it is not true? You can just give one example where the predecessor of a three-digit number is two-digit number. So you can try three-digit number as 100. Three digit number is 100. 100 minus 1 is 99. And 99 is 2-digit number. So we have seen the predecessor of 3-digit number 100 is 99. 99 is 2-digit number. And what is given in the question? The predecessor of a 3-digit number can never be a 2-digit number. It is false. False. It is false. So the given statement is false. Because we have seen the example. Mute the microphone. Mute the microphone. Every day the problem is there. Same problem with same student. Definitely I will not admit for 1 week. Just whoever friend is there, you just pass the message that sir will not admit from next week. Because every time you need a reminder, which is not possible every time. Now D part. So the given statement is false. Because in the question you are given, the predecessor of a 3-digit number can never be a 2-digit number. We have seen the example. Huh? Yes? Send me the request, I will admit. We have seen the example of a 3-digit number 100. When we find predecessor of 100 minus 1, it is 99. 99 is a 2-digit number. So the given statement is false. Now D, the successor of 1-digit number is 1-digit number only. The successor of a 1-digit number. Yes, very good. The successor of a 1-digit number is 1-digit number only. See, this is given only. The successor of 1-digit number can be 1-digit, but it can also be 2-digit also. But it is given only. Means only it is a 2-digit number. The successor of a 1-digit number is a 1-digit number only. The successor of a 1-digit number is 1-digit number only. You can give the example. You can give the example. 1-digit number 9. 1-digit number you can give, that is 9. Successor we add 1. 9 plus 1 is 10. And this 10 is a 2-digit number. 10 is a 2-digit number. So the given statement is false. Because the successor of a 1-digit number can be 1-digit number, it can also be 2-digit number. But we are given only 1-digit number. So the given statement is false. Then E part. All natural numbers are whole number. All natural numbers are whole numbers. We can see that all natural numbers are whole number. You can see the natural number. What is the natural number? Natural number start from 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on. Then whole number start from 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. You check whether all natural numbers are present in whole number. 1 is present here. 2 is present here, 3 is present here, 4 is there, 5 is there. Yes, so answer is true. Because all natural numbers are whole number. Because all natural numbers, they are present in whole number. So all natural numbers are whole number. But whether it is other way it is true, all whole numbers are natural number? Yes, tell me. False. Yes. Because, yes. Yes. Even all natural numbers are whole number. I have written natural number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, --. Whole number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, --. All natural number 1 is present, 2 is present, 3 is there, 4 is there, 5 is there. So all natural zero, we are talking about natural numbers are there in. It is true, because all natural numbers, they are present in whole number. But all whole number are not natural number, because zero is a whole number, which is not there in the natural number. So when it is all whole numbers are natural number, then it is false. But whenever it is all natural numbers are whole number, then it is true. Now next is, yes, if the whole number zero has, the whole number zero has no predecessor. The whole number zero has no predecessor. If you see the whole number, it starts from zero. 1, 2, 3, 4, dash, dash, dash. Is there any whole number before zero? No. So the answer is true. Zero has no predecessor. But whether zero has successor? Yes. One. So the whole number zero. No, my dear. See, if you talk about predecessor of zero, then minus one. Minus one is not a whole number. Are you getting? Predecessor of zero is minus one, but minus one is not a whole number. No. Yes. Negative numbers are called integers. That you will see afterwards in 7th standard. Negative numbers are called. So this we see in the number line system. So, yes. Before this we have minus 1, but minus 1 is not a whole number. Minus 1 is not a whole number. The predecessor of 0 is minus 1, but minus 1 is not a whole number. And what is there? The whole number 0 has no predecessor. Yes, the whole number 0 has no predecessor, because the predecessor of 0 is minus 1, but minus 1 is not a whole number. That means 0 has no predecessor, correct. But 0 has successor as 1. Then G, 1 is the smallest natural number. 1 is the smallest natural number. True, yes. 1 is the smallest natural number. 1 is the smallest natural number. And you can see the natural number. It starts from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, dash, dash, dash. And this is the smallest. This is the smallest. Natural number is 1. So answer is true, because 1 is the smallest natural number. 1 is the smallest natural number, so the given statement is true. Is it clear? Yes. Now we see the number line. Now we will see the number line. That G, I have written natural number start from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 1 I have circled, and 1 is the smallest. So the given statement is true. The given statement is true because 1 is the smallest natural number. What is the largest natural number? Yes, understood. Very good. All of you have understood. Very good. That there is no largest natural number, but there is the smallest natural number, which is 1. There is the smallest natural number, which is 1. Clear? Smallest. 1 I have circled, and that I have written smallest. Now let us see the downward. This is smallest. 1 I have circled, and below that I have written smallest. And the given statement is true. because 1 is the smallest natural number.
What is the smallest whole number? 0.
Correct. Yes. Okay. Now let us continue further. That is called our number line. Write down everything in the notebook. Number line. Title. We will see number line. Here, we will see the number line. This is my number line. Number line has arrow at both the end. Arrow means it can be extended. Extended means you can stretch. You can go towards left. Draw this diagram. You can go towards left. You can go towards right also. Arrow means it can be extended towards left and right. So arrow means it can be extended towards left and towards right. So in the number line, in the center we have 0. Try to understand easily, no problem. When we move from 0 to right, this is my right side. This is my right. And this is my left. When we move towards right, we get positive numbers. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and dash. They are positive numbers. Positive numbers. Positive numbers means plus sign. And when we move to left, we get negative numbers. That is -1, -2, -3, -4, and --. There is a continuation. Dash means continuation. So this -1, -2, -3, -4, they are called negative numbers. Negative numbers means minus sign. Negative number means minus sign. And draw this. And this zero is neither positive nor negative. Zero has no sign. Zero is neither positive. Zero is neither positive nor negative. That means zero has no sign. So zero is the only number which has no sign, plus sign or minus sign. Zero is the only number which has neither plus sign nor minus sign. So on this number line, when we move from zero to right, we get positive numbers. On this number line, when we move to left, we get negative numbers. So on the number line, when we move from zero to right, we get positive numbers. And when we move from 0 to left, we get negative numbers. So this point you have to write down in the wordings also. Yes, everything we have to write. So write down this first. From 0, when we move. From 0 when we move towards downward, I have written 0 0 is neither positive plus nor negative minus. So from 0, when we move towards right, that means in this way, we get positive numbers. Positive means plus sign numbers. From 0, when we move towards right, we get positive numbers. Second, from 0, when we move towards left, left means in this way, we get negative numbers, that is minus sign. Negative number means the number will have minus sign. Negative number means the number will have minus signs. Here, yes, so now we get one more negative numbers. Now we will see our number system. Just now somebody asked, sir, what are negative numbers? Negative numbers are called integers. That we will see. Next, see, this is 0. This is 1. Write down. -1, -2. Mute the microphone. Draw this, my dear. Draw this. Natural numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on. Natural numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then we have seen whole number. What are natural number? Natural number are 1. Wait, my dear. Then whole number. We have seen whole number. Whole number starts from 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, dash. Then there is a new concept that is called Z. This Z is my called integers. I means integer, or I also for integers. Now what are integers? Integers are negative numbers, 0 and positive numbers. Integers are negative numbers, 0 and positive numbers. So your integer I or Z will have negative integer, then minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, and then we write dash. So integers are negative numbers. Yes, negative and positive both numbers are contained in integers. Negative and positive both numbers are contained in negative. Minus means negative, 0, and plus means positive. Minus V means negative, plus V means positive. So now let us represent these integers on the number line. Let us represent these integers on the number line. Let us represent these integers on the number line. So write down this. Write down this. Exercise 1.4 now we start. Exercise 1.4. Represent the following on the number line. Represent the following numbers. Represent the following numbers on the number line. Number line. Also write. Which number lies to the right of other on the line? Now first it is 2 and 6. We have to represent number 2 and number 6 on the number line. Is it clear? First we have to represent number 2 on the number line. Then we have to represent number 6 on the number line. Is it clear? So how you will represent number 2 and number 6? We draw the number line. Yes. We draw the number line right here. See this part. Now how will represent 2? See this. So we draw the number line. We draw the number line. In the number line we have 0. This is my left. This is my right. Then somewhere we have 1. Then we have 2. Then we have 3. Then we have 4. Then we have 5. Then we have 6. Okay. Now how you will represent 2? We want to represent 2 and 6. No. So you have to write down. To represent 2. Write down this. To represent 2. On the number line, to represent 2 on the number line, we move two steps to the right of zero. To represent number 2 on the number line, we move 2 steps to the right of 0. Is it clear? We move 2 steps to the right of 0. So now this is 0. From 0 you move 2 steps. So this is one step. This is other step. So this is my number 2. Are you waiting? This is my number 2. To represent number 2 on the number line, we move 2 steps to the right because this is plus sign. So whenever you want to move, you want to represent plus number, you have to move right. Then to represent 6, the right. To represent 6. On the number line. What is 6? Positive or negative? Positive. So you will move toward the right. To represent 6 on the number line. We move. We move 6 steps to the right of 0. we move 6 steps to the right of 0. To right of 0, we move 6 steps. Now, on this number line only. Now, let us... No, my dear. You have to move 6 steps now. So, this is 1 step, 2 step, 3 step, 4 step, 5 step, 6 step. So, this is my number 6. So, to represent plus 6 on the number line, we move 6 steps to the right. Why we move to the right? Tell me. Why we move to the right? Because numbers are plus sign. Yes. Yes. Now you can see the. Now we have represented both the number on the number line. 2 and 6. Now you tell me which number is to the right. Tell me. No. My dear, this is 2, this is 6. 2 is to the left of 6. No. Where is 2? On the left. Where is 6? On the right. No. 6 is on the right of 2. So, right, number 6 is to the right of, number 6 is to the right of number 2. Number 6 is to the right of number 2. Number 6 is to the right of number 2. That's all. Because 6 is on the right. Which number is on the left? 2 is to the left of 6. And 6 is to the right of 2. No. This is my right side. 6 is to the right of 2. Is it clear? Now all of you do 5 and 1. Chalo. B part 5 and 1. You have to write down in the same way. You have to draw the line, then you have to show this and write down this. 5 and 1. Do it 5 and 1. Chalo. Do it 5 and 1. Do it 5 and 1. B is homework. 5 and 1 is homework. Then C. Same way. All this. This also you have to write. Yes, my dear, again, for each problem you have to write separately. Minus 3 and 7. D is minus 2 and 0. D is minus 2 and 0. And E is minus 4 and 3. Minus 4 and 3. Let me solve. D and E will be homework. C I will do. Minus 3 and minus 7 I will do. Minus 3 and minus 7 I will do. And then we have to write which number is to the right of which number. So draw the number line. This is minus 7, minus 3. So both are negative. So this side we write 0. Then this is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, and minus 7. Okay. Now how you will represent minus 3? To represent minus 3, yes, my dear. To represent minus 3 on the number line, what you will do? To represent minus 3 on the number line, yes, what you will do? Tell me. We move 3 steps. Yes. We move 3 steps. Very good. We move 3 steps to the left of 0. Because this is minus 3. We move 3 steps to the left of 0. So 3 steps, 1, then 2, then 3. This is minus 3. And this is left step. We move left. 3 steps left to the 0. Then to represent minus, to represent minus 7, we move, yes, anybody, we move, we move 7 steps, we move 7 steps to the left, because this is minus, to the left of 0. This is my right, this is my left. So let us move 7 steps to the left. So 1 step, 2 step, 3 step, 4 step, 5 step, 6 step, 7 step. This is my number minus 7. This is my number, yes. 1 number line. Now you tell me, other color pen, different. Any pen, red, blue, black, whichever you want. Now see here, now which number is to the right, tell me, which number is to the right? For jumps you can use different color pen. Which number is to the right? Yes, minus 3 is my to the right. So right, minus 3 is to the right of minus 7. Minus 3 is to the right of minus 7. Because this is my left side, this is my right side, which is there? Minus 3 is to the right of minus 7. Yes. Yes, my dear. So now we stop here. It is 10:31. Yes. So do all this homework. Now we stop here. Bye. 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 Bye, everybody. Bye, everybody.